Hey, welcome back, my awesome students. So in this section here, what I want to do is I want to create a small project or a project that has a, you know, many of the features that we learned already, but even other extra features that you guys don't know about. So that way I can show you more stuff. So that way you know how to create real life projects out there and can better depend on yourself. Okay, so let's go ahead and start from scratch. I want to create maybe a admin panel where I have the user's data, where we can create data, and maybe a front end where we can display that data, edit that data in the back end, and do all kinds of stuff, okay? So let's go ahead and play a little bit with a new project. So I'm gonna go to my terminal here. And by the way, guys, I have some templates here in this section. So make sure that you download them. It's gonna be project assets. It's gonna be like a zip folder or something. And there you're gonna have a admin folder where we're gonna have our admin templates, blog home, and a blog post. For some of my existing students, we've done something very similar before, but this is gonna be using Bootstrap 4, okay? So, and for those of you that, you know, went through the section already, where we created like a little admin panel there to the, that I show you a little example, that's what we're gonna do here on the first lectures. But then we're gonna take it a little bit further and we're gonna start creating new lectures, okay? So I'm gonna start from scratch. I'm gonna go to where my code is, and I'm gonna go to a place I call Playground, okay? And then here I'm gonna create my new project, okay? So I'm just gonna go here and say, you know what? This is just gonna be a new CMS system. I'm just gonna call it like this. All right. Now, for those of you that are using, I'm gonna be using Valet. That's another way of installing Laravel without using PHP Artisan Serve command. So don't worry too much about it. I'm just using an extension like that test. I explained all that stuff in the beginning of the course. Okay. But you can use PHP Artisan, you can use that terminal command there to see your project in the browser, okay? So I'm gonna go to the browser here, and I'm gonna say new CMS system, just like that, dot test. Okay, and there you go, we have a new Laravel installation. For those of you that are using PHP Artisan Serve, go ahead and do that and go to your browser to see your results in the 8000 port. Okay, so I'm done with that. Make sure you download the project assets because that's exactly what we're going to start doing right now. We're going to start putting those assets in the project. Okay, so I'm going to go, first of all, let's make sure that we go to the public folder here. And the folder that you're gonna download, and we're gonna go to blog home. And here we're gonna, as a matter of fact, you know what? Let's go to admin and drop the vendor folder for admin in the public directory. Okay. So that's doing that there. Let's go to my ID is acting up on me. Actually, my ID just finished. All right, I had to pause the video. But anyway, so that's the first thing there, the admin folder and then the vendor folder. You see the blog home has a vendor folder too, but all it has there is jQuery and Bootstrap, and we have that already in the admin here. Bootstrap and jQuery, okay? So let's go ahead and do the rest. So I'm gonna go to blog home and the CSS there, I'm gonna drop it in the, as a matter of fact, let's come back here. Before we do that, let's create the CSS folders. And the way we're gonna do that is by downloading a user interface. It's called UI from Laravel, little package that will allow us to have authentication in our projects, okay? So you guys already know how to do this. We did this in the front end section. But just in case you did not and you skipped it, let's do it again right here. So composer, require, and Laravel UI. Okay, let's do that. Oh, did I misspell this? Always. My English is not very good looking this time. All right, so that's downloading there. I want you to keep something in mind, okay? That package there is gonna give us the ability to have authentication in our system, but we still have to make some modifications there. I'm gonna show you how to do that. But now that we download the user interface package from Laravel, we can bootstrap our project in Vue, like with Vue.js framework, with Bootstrap or with React, even probably they already have more by the time you're watching this, okay? So we gotta do PHP Artisan, the user interface, whatever user interface we want. Now I want Bootstrap, and this is by default is going to do the Bootstrap 4. Okay, maybe by the time you're watching this, it's already Bootstrap 5 or 6 or 7. So you might want to take a look how to download specific versions of Bootstrap when using the PHP Artisan UI command. Maybe by the time you're watching this, Bootstrap 7, and you do at 7. So you got to look at the documentation for that. But this is going to download the latest version right now. So I'm just going to go with the latest version. Okay? And I want the authentication system here. So I put that flag there. Now I'm going to do npm run. NPM install first, and then the ampersand here for doing the second command, npm run dev. Okay, that's going to install the JavaScript side of our project that we need. And you're gonna see some new folders right here in the view directory. Right here, you're gonna see auth layouts. Okay, you're gonna see a home. And we're gonna see some new routes right here. Controller, home controller, and in the web routes right here, you're gonna see the routes right here and the controller home, okay? As you can see, finish compiling, okay? For those of you that don't know what's going on, basically, we are running some commands that are here in package.json, and they are downloading all these dependencies here, okay? And the npm run dev is executing this command here, that it's executing this command that does webpack, which is gonna compile a bunch of files that we got in the resources right here, like SAS. Okay, it's gonna be compiling all this stuff and putting everything in the public directory. You see, we got a new CSS folder, JavaScript, and this one we put here ourselves, okay? So now that we have that, what we need to do is in here, drop what we wanted to drop before from the CSS folder right here. I wanted to drop blog home.css. I'm gonna drop it right there. I also want to drop, go to the blog post, and I want to drop the blog post CSS in there. And I want to go to admin. As a matter of fact, hold on, before we finish the blog, blog home, that's fine. Yeah, let's go to admin now. I thought it was another file there that we needed. I'm going to go and drop this one in there, admin. To CSS, and now this one has a JS file. So I'm gonna drop that in there as well. So to the JavaScript, and then that right there. Okay, if you want, you can use the minification version, which is called .min, okay? So once we have that, okay, we started our project in the right direction. All right, so let's go to the next lecture where we're going to be putting this together. But for now, this is all we need. Okay, guys, thank you so much, and I'll see you on the next lecture.